is Michelle Cullen with Astronomy 103A. This video is going to help you use your night sky planisphere. A planisphere, otherwise known as a star chart or a star wheel, is a reliable, low-tech device that can help you identify constellations and stars in the night sky at different times throughout the year. There are different types of planispheres, and so you're going to want to make sure that you have one that roughly corresponds to your latitude. You can look on it to see what it is. The most common is 30 to 40 degrees north latitude for people who live in North America. And with that planisphere, you could use it from roughly San Diego to Vancouver, as you have about 10 degrees extra on either side of the 30 to 40 degrees. In Alaska, you at 60 degrees latitude, you would want one that corresponds for that. But it's difficult to get those. So for this one, we're going to use a planisphere that has from 40 to 50 degrees that are readily available online. Okay, let's get started with how to use it. I'm going to show you a two-sided planisphere, and notice that one side has a north horizon on it, just on the blue line, and the other has, if you flip it over, the south horizon. So we'll look at that blue curve, which is a horizon, and look, you'll notice that if we look north, you'll have the word west on the left and east on the right, and that's corresponding to those directions and the stars that are in that part of the sky. So the first thing you're going to want to do, now that we have the right planisphere, is to set the time and date. And we'll do that by the date and time that you want to set your observation for. So we're going to assume that today is January 28th at 7 o'clock in the evening. So we're going to rotate the wheel and line it up with the date on the to the time on the outer edge of the wheel. And if you're in a part of the country that has daylight savings time, you can subtract an hour to be exact. Notice that the blue edge on the bottom of the oval represents the northern horizon. And when you hold it at arm's length, slightly over your head, you can line it up with the stars that you'll be able to see during that time. If you wanted to turn your body to the right, if you were facing north, and turn to the east, you'll be able to see that those are the stars on the east. And so just turn your star wheel so that the word east is actually horizontal, and then hold it up as you face east, and those were the stars you'll be able to see. The same thing for west. Just rotate your star chart to the left, and you'll be able to see the word west. Let's say now we want to look at the stars that are behind us, if we were looking north, that are in the southern horizon, above the southern horizon. So to do that with this particular planisphere, you're going to flip it over and look at the other side without changing the date or time. And that is the south horizon. So if you spin the wheel so you're looking at the stars later in the evening on the same day, you can see how the stars will be rising in the east and setting in the west as you go later and later in the evening or the night. And you might notice that they seem to be rotating around a fixed point, which is actually the rivet in the center of your star wheel. This point is the celestial pole, and of course if you were on the North Pole, right at the North Pole, that celestial pole would be directly overhead of the North Pole, the point where the Earth is spinning around. But since most of us aren't on the North Pole, we're at a certain latitude, you'll find that that angle of the celestial pole is corresponding to your latitude. It turns out that it's very close to the North Star, which we call Polaris. It's not exactly, but it's close enough, so it looks like all of the stars are spinning around Polaris. You can notice too that the star Polaris is the instar in the Little Dipper constellation, which is an asterism, the Little Dipper, in the constellation Ursa Minor. If you want to see constellations on your star chart, you'll notice that they are written in capital letters. Bright stars within the constellations are written with a capital letter at the beginning, but the rest in small letters. And if you look closer at your star chart, you'll notice that the brightest stars on the chart are represented by larger dots, which is very useful if you're trying to find bright stars. You can see which ones correspond. And it is really helpful if your sky has a little bit of haze from clouds or there's some city lights that are blocking out most of the stars. You will only be able to see the brightest stars. And that sometimes actually makes it easier to find certain constellations because you're not overwhelmed with so many stars to try to figure out what is what. Take another look at your star wheel and you will see that there's a dotted line that arcs across it and it's labeled the ecliptic. This is a line that the sun traces its path across the sky during the day, and it's also the path of which the planets appear to move across during the night when we can see them. Your planisphere also has some symbols that you can see for different objects that you might be able to see with binoculars. There's things like globular star clusters, nebula, and such. Okay, now let's look at another easy-to-view constellation and see how it changes throughout the night. On January 28th in the evening, you should be able to see Orion in the south, slightly east sky. Orion is one of the most easily identifiable constellations in the winter sky because there are three stars that are very bright that make up the belt of Orion. And then there is a bright star, Rigel, below the belt. Again, if you look on your constellation chart, your star chart, you'll be able to see that there's sort of a spilled milky ink blot, which is actually the Milky Way stars located behind Orion. Let's move the planisphere and change the time on it until it's midnight on January 28th. And you can see how Orion appears to move from across the night sky as you face south. It will appear to move from the east to the west. And if you're facing south, that's not a big surprise because that's the same direction that the sun would rise in the east and set in the west. And all of the stars, if you're facing south, will rise in the east and move across the sky in an arc and set in the west. One thing that you might notice is that the stars will rise earlier each night as you progress to different dates. You can look at the constellation and see what time it rises each month, the same constellation. And it would turn out that if you looked at Orion, it would be about 2 hours earlier each month, and so this corresponds to about 4 minutes each day. So in this lab, I want you to think about what would cause that. Well, this is your basic introduction to using the planisphere. Remember, when you go out into the night sky, bundle up. If it's cold outside, it's the Alaska winter, and some helpful things would be to have a red flashlight to help you view your planisphere and help preserve your night vision. If you're not sure where north is and to even how to find Polaris, you could use a compass or a map. Remember, north is always on the top of the map, and so that can help you find the general direction. And once you find Polaris, you can use that to find all of the stars around Polaris, the circumpolar stars. And then once you find some other basic constellations, you'll be able to use those to help you move throughout the night sky to see other ones. So good luck. I hope you have clear skies and happy stargazing.